Well, thank you, Leon, for those kind words. Well, let's get started here. I want to talk today about work I'm doing on a new battery. It's an aluminum molten salt battery, and it's designed for off-grid power supply. The problem that we're attacking is the intermittency of renewable sources of electrical energy. What happens when the sun doesn't shine? What happens when the wind doesn't blow? And the term of art is long duration power delivery. That is to say 4 hours up to us, and at scale means tens to hundreds of kilowatt hours. And by the way, lithium ion doesn't work at this application. It fails, first of all, at cost. It's still far too high. It's unsafe. The larger lithium ion becomes, the greater the threat of fire. And we all are familiar with how the battery fades in its ability to deliver charge. And the lifetime is just too short for this application. So we have to find something else. And so my proposal is to innovate in the battery chemistry. And what I've been working on is a combination of aluminum and sulfur. And the electrolyte cannot be aqueous. It has to be something other than water. So we've resorted to molten salts. And the really exciting piece here is that the capital cost of these components is very low. We're forecasting 5% that of lithium ion batteries today. And we've done the work at MIT. We've reduced it to practice in the laboratory. And then with the Desponde Center funding, we're now looking at scaling it up and moving it towards commercialization. Just so that you have a picture of what this is all about, you have three layers here. The bottom layer is aluminum, metal, that's the negative electrode. The opposite electrode is elemental sulfur. And in between, we have a molten salt of the electrolyte. Sulfur is an insulator, so in order to give it some electronic conductivity, we have to mix it with some carbon. And then we have an aluminum current collector on the backside of the sulfur electrode. To prevent shorting, we put a little bit of a spacer in here. It could be polymer, it could be fiberglass. And then if we want to coil this up into a jelly roll configuration, we have another insulator on the backside of one of the current collectors. And so there it is. We've done considerable work. Last Monday, I sent off this manuscript Nature, in which we talk about how fast we can charge this battery and do so without the risk of dendrites, these needle-like protrusions from the electrode shorting across and causing fire. So here's a few examples of data from here. I draw your attention to the red lines. The one that's moving up is the charging line, and the one that moves left to right descending, that's the discharge. And you can see it's a plateau at around 1 volt, and it goes out to about 1,000 milliamp hours per gram, which is a respectable amount of charge, and the D over 5 means 5-hour discharge cycle. This thing can also work under very, very rapid charging. So the blue on the left is 10C. That means 1/10 of an hour. That's 6 minutes to go to full charge. And on the right, the red, that's 100C. That's 1/100 of an hour. That's 36 seconds to go from zero to full charge. And you can see that this is not some kind of capacitive storage. The fact that at 100C, we get 300 milliamp hours per gram, that means this is really charging the battery. So this is fantastic. And all of these are discharged in 2 hours. Now, how's the thing compare with today's lithium ion battery? With our early work, we estimate about 742 watt hours per liter. And if you compare that to a very, very well-developed resource lithium ion battery, this has nickel, manganese, cobalt, it's 804. You know, these are differences without distinction. Aluminum sulfur is in the ballpark. But where things are really differentiated is here in the capital cost. Aluminum sulfur is $2.40 per kilowatt hour for the cost of the aluminum sulfur and the salt. and compare that to the projections on lithium ion for that nickel manganese cobalt unit I'd shown you, that's $47 per kilowatt hour. So we're down below 5% of the cost of lithium ion. This is really, really good. So what's next? I've started a company. It's called Avanti Battery Company. It's in Charlestown, only 2 miles away from MIT campus. And it's been established to try to commercialize this, this new invention. And so if we ask something, we would say we're seeking funding for Series A. And that means money to de-risk and bring this technology to market at scale. And that means we're going to build something that is the size of, say, a part of power an iPhone, 4,000 milliamp hours. And that's where we are. Thank you. And thanks to the Desponde Center for its support.